Hello, welcome to the Delicious Kitchen. Today I'm going to make a simple vanilla custard. So what I'm going to do first is take the seeds from this vanilla pod. We want to scrape the seeds but also keep the vanilla pod to infuse the milk. So I'm just going to slice it gently down the middle and surprise it open with your knife or your fingers. All in all, the whole vanilla pod's going to go in. So just going to keep that on the edge of the knife. Going to pour the milk into our pan. That's 450 millilitres. Put it on a gentle heat. You want to bring it to the boil, but gently, because overboiled milk is not very nice and it can burn the bottom of the pan. So I'm going to put my vanilla pods in and scrape the seeds off into the pan. Back off. Give it a bit of a stir. We want to bring that to the boil, then let it infuse for about 10 minutes so that the flavour really gets in there. While the milk and the vanilla are coming to the boil, I'm going to whisk 4 free-range eggs with 2 tablespoons of sugar. This is what's going to thicken the custard eventually.
What's that funky spoon you're using there, Rosie?
This is a measuring spoon. Tablespoon, push it in, half a tablespoon, teaspoon, half a teaspoon. Very clever piece of equipment. So I'm just going to whisk them together. The more I whisk, the paler the eggs will become and the fluffier the mixture, but we don't necessarily need that for this. We just want the sugar and the eggs to be combined. So I've whisked the egg with the sugar, and our milk's been infusing here with vanilla pod for about 10 minutes. So I'm just going to pour that in. And as it goes in, just give it a really good stir. Doesn't matter if the vanilla pod goes in at this point. Don't mind staying in the pan. Because we're going to strain it anyway. So I'm just going to give this a really good stir so that all is combined. Okay, so I've given that a good stir. I'm now going to strain it through a sieve into a clean saucepan. Put it back on the heat. And let it simmer until it starts to thicken. To test that the custard's ready, just give it a good stir. Get the custard on the back of the spoon. Run your finger down it and the custard will stay in its place. You can either leave your custard to cool, pour it into an airtight container and keep it in the fridge for a few days, or you can serve it warm over apple crumble.